Hello student, welcome in biology practical. Today we are going to learn how to make a slide for a compound microscope to visualize any biological object under the compound microscope. In this practical, we are going to make a slide of a plant material. In this plant, how to visualize the tissue inside the plant stem by making a slide. Requirement for making a slide, and that are a slide, this is a slide, and cover slip also, a watch glass, most important that is a new fine blade, the glycerin, blotting paper, water, dissection box. In the dissection box there are so many tools for making a slide or to dissect any biological object. So dissection box is there, and most important lastly, that is a compound microscope. Let's start how to make a slide of biological object. At first, take a plant material. These are the leaves. We have to study the stem or the tissues which are present inside the stem. We are going to visualize that tissue by making a slide. We know that in the stem there are so many conducting tissues in the stems are there. Out of that, xylem, phloem. The phloem is responsible for conduction of the food material inside the plant, and the xylems, which are responsible for the conduction of water from the root up to the upper shoot region of that plant. So we are going to take a section. That section is also called as transverse section, because in this case this is a stem and this is the axis, and this angle is the axis of that stem. And if we take a perpendicular section of that stem, that section will be called as the transverse section. Let's see how to take a transverse section. At first, if you need to take a section from here, at first you have to make a sharp cut. It is a blunt end of that stem. You have to make it sharp by using a blade. Place a slide below the stem. After that, make a sharp cut of that material. Take off the unwanted material, then make another cut so that you can hold that piece easily in your hand. Let's leave that plant as it is. Plant. Now we have a piece of the stem. After getting a material, then take a watch glass, and in that watch glass have some water inside it. Some water I have taken. Then take a section only after preparation of the watch glass. As soon as you take a section, that section should be placed in the water. If not, then the section may have dried, or the tissue will get dry. Then take a section. Now I am taking a section, and that section should be very fine and entire. After taking a section, that section should be placed inside that water. I am taking another section. Take 2 to 3 sections, so as entire and thinnest section will be selected after that. This is how I am taking a section. A fine section should be taken in a single jerk of that attempt, and place that section into the water. There are another sections also. After taking 5 to 6 sections, now this end become very blunt. I am going to make that sharp. Now I am taking another attempt to make a fine section. Okay, like this you have to take a section, and transfer that section inside a watch glass. Now I have taken so many sections of that stem. Now I am selecting out the unwanted sections which are broader enough of no use. I am selecting out some sections which are comparatively very thin. I will that section will be remain as it is inside the watch glass. To visualize the conducting tissues, we use the safranin stain. The area where the cellulose is present, only that area will be seen as a colored of the safranin. Safranin has red color. This is a safranin. I am going to use this safranin inside this watch glass. Some amount of safranin is added. Place this watch glass as it is for 10 minutes. Okay, now 10 minutes are over. After 10 minutes, these all sections, they should be transferred in the water for washing purpose. Now I am transferring the sections in the water. You can use the brush to transfer this section in the water. Now I am transferring these sections into the water. All the sections, there are four sections, they are now been transferred in the water, and this is for the washing purpose. Or extra safranin which is remaining there inside that section, that extra safranin will be washed off with the help of this water. Now the washing is done. After this, I am going to make a slide of this section. This I am taking that sections aside. Take a clean glass slide. I am taking a black background so as the slide will be seen very clearly. I am taking a black background because the slide will be seen very clearly. Now on this slide add a drop of glycerin. This is a glycerin, this is a bottle of glycerin. Add the glycerin on this slide. The glycerin is used for making a slide because it has so many properties. Because glycerin doesn't evaporate in the room temperature, there is another reason, that is glycerin is neutral, or it cannot make any chemical reactions with the biological object. Now I am selecting a section for making a slide here. This section is very thin, or thinnest section. I am selecting the thinnest section. If you use, I am taking a thinnest section for making a slide. If you use a brush, then it is very helpful, or it is very easy to transfer the section from wash glass up to the slide. I am transferring the section in this glycerin. There is a section, that section is transferred in glycerin. One more reason is there for using the glycerin, that is, but the refractive index of glass and refractive index of glycerin is similar, or same refractive index of both has, the glass and glycerin. And as the glycerin doesn't evaporate in room temperature, the slide can be remain as it is for a longer time. You can make a slide by using water also, but water has so many drawbacks. Water can be evaporate in room temperature. After making a slide using the water, the slide may dry or the specimen also may dry. Most of the case or generally, the glycerin should be used for making a slide. A slide, I am putting a cover slip on slide. It is very skillful process to place a cover slip on slide. I am placing the cover slip on slide in such a way that no air bubble can be formed. Like that, I have released the forceps only, and the one end of that forceps is there behind or below the cover slip. Away. I have placed the cover slip on slide. There is little bit air bubble trapped inside the glycerin. That air bubble should be removed such a way that okay, that air bubble is now at another side. Okay, such a way I have done a, I have made a slide. There is extra or unwanted glycerin is there. With the help of blotting paper, you have to blot that extra glycerin from the slide. Okay, there is I have done the blot of excess of glycerin on slide. I am now cleaning the slide. Always prepare a clean slide so that if you are going to show the slide to the examiner, that examiner will be impressed by seeing only the slide with naked eye without any microscope. The clean slide should be done like this. Okay, now we have done this slide of a transfer section of plant material. We are using this compound microscope to see the slide under it. Now at first adjust the 10x and make sure that the objective lens are very clean. I am cleaning the objective lens. This is the primary process of using the compound microscope to clean the lenses. Then make sure that light is there, or sufficient light is there. Yes, there is light. Make sure that the bottom of that slide is clean, because if it is dirty or any excess of glycerin is remaining there, the stage of that microscope will be damaged. That is, now I am placing the slide on the stage and in such a way that our object, or this is the object, red color object is there. That object should be there at a straight line. Just below the 10x objective lens. If you have to view or you have to see the object up to the 100x time or 100 time more magnification, place the objective lens of 10x and make sure the distance will be 1 centimeter, approximate 1 centimeter. No need to use the scale. After this, I am, by using the coarse adjustment screw, I am adjusting, or I am, at first I am finding the object. Where is my object? Yes, this is my object. I have found that object under the microscope, and now I am moving or adjusting this coarse adjustment screw. And after adjusting the screw, the object is seen, but light intensity is much more. I am
no need of such light intensity. Now, by using the diaphragm or the iris adjustment, the light intensity is, this can be controlled, and sufficient light will be trapped or sufficient light will be used to see the sight. Okay, now the slide is done, and the with the help of safranin, the conducting tissues are well stained. You can see the slide under the microscope. So this is about the making a slide, how to make a slide and how to see the temporary slide under the light microscope. What if you have to magnify the image up to 450 times more? For that purpose, you have to change the objective lens. You cannot move the rotating disc without moving the body tube upside, because if you rotate directly the rotating disc, the slide may damage, because this is a, you can see that this is a 10x objective lens and this is a 45x objective lens. It is longer. If you move the this rotating disc directly, that longer lens will damage your slide. That is why at first you have to move the body tube upward direction like this. After moving, you should change, or you can change. Such sound is here, that is a confirmation that the objective lens is aligned correctly. Now, in case of 10x lens, the distance between slide and objective lens was approximate 1 cm, but now in case of 45x objective lens, the distance between slide and objective lens will be this much closer, that is approximate 1 mm. So confirm that the distance between slide and objective lens is approximate 1 mm. After that, I am, with the help of eyepiece, I am going to see the slide, and then I am moving the coarse adjustment screw. But here the light intensity or adjustment of light intensity was for the previous lens, that was the 10x objective lens. Here it needs more light, that is why I am going to increase the light intensity for this slide, and I am moving the slide so that the area or the vascular bundle of that plant will be seen very correctly or very clearly under the objective lens. Now here, with the help of coarse adjustment screw, you cannot make a fine image. The rotation of or the movement of body tube with the help of coarse adjustment screw is very high, that is why I cannot make a fine image of that slide. Now I am moving the fine adjustment screw. With the help of fine adjustment screw, I can adjust a lens in such a way that the image can be seen correctly or clearly. So this is the image, and I am seeing this image very clearly, adjusting some amount of light. If the light intensity is decreased, very dark image is there. Now a sufficient amount of light is there. So this is the way how the 450 times more magnification is done in this another type of objective lens. So this is the way to see the slide under the light microscope. And in this video lecture, we have learned about how to prepare a slide and how to view a slide under the compound microscope. Thank you.